PR production. I'll be interviewing a young guy from Kuwait. His name is Mohammed Al-Sarraf. Hey, Mohammed,
hey.
How are you?
Pretty good.
So you're from Kuwait, right?
Yep.
What's your native language?
My native language is Arabic.
Nice. Do you speak other languages?
Yep, I speak English and a little bit of Spanish because I took two classes.
What is the most celebrated holiday in your country?
The most celebrated holiday is going to be the Kuwaiti National Day, which is on the February the 24th and February the 25th.
What sports do you play in Kuwait? Do you have like your main thing? Do you have soccer, tennis, baseball?
I think we have soccer. We have pretty much all the other sports, but soccer is the most popular sport over there.
How about food? What's your favorite?
Oh, food.
Culture.
Food. We got variety of food over there, but my favorite dish is gonna be the mendi, which is meat and rice, which cooked like in a hole in the ground with coal. And it takes hours to get cooked.
Nice. So tell me, how about education? The educational system in here?
Educational system? Oh, the education is pretty good in Kuwait. Because like for the citizens, you have free education from the first grade until you finish college. And sometimes even you can get a higher degree, like a master's degree or PhD, and the country support everything, so you get everything free if you are a citizen.
Okay, so studying in the United States and finishing from Jacksonville State University, would it be more, you would be more valuable for employers, like they'll hire you faster than
people? Yes, I think so, because they value the students who go study abroad, overseas, because they usually get more experience and they experience different languages, so they are like more professional. They would be more professional than the people who's been like studying their whole life in Kuwait.
Okay, so what is the biggest misconception people have about Kuwaitis?
I've never heard any about like any misconceptions about Kuwait, but because we got a good like relationship with all other countries. We also export oil for major countries, so I've never like been in a situation where it was a misconception about Kuwait.
Okay, so culture-wise, how did you adjust from here? Like, was it different?
The only big difference was the language and how you express yourself. Because sometimes I might say things that offend somebody, and I don't know. But that was just in the beginning when I first came here. But after I like had an experience and I got friends and I learned from other people and from college, so I got really better.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much, sir.
Thank you.
Nice seeing you.
Nice meeting you.